Hello everyone. I just wanted to quickly showcase my first test of developing a tiny plugin for InDesign using UXP. It's nothing much, but just getting started with it, and wanted to share some of the tips and tricks I already learned for maybe those of you who, similar to me, are already familiar with UXP, but not so much with InDesign. There are already a few quirks that I found out that I can maybe show to you. All right, let's dive right into it. What does the plugin do that I have created? I mean, it's basically just a simple test plugin with a little panel, and the actual functionality behind it is something that I personally actually find useful, because I do a lot of advocacy in terms of LGBTQIA+ rights and all things related to that, and so I often have to insert one or another pride flag into the document. And so what I created is a plugin that can simply insert a page that basically contains as a background the pride flag. So for example, I could now add a trans flag to the document. As you can see, it adds these colors of the trans flag. It also adds these swatches in a separate folder in here so that you can adjust them freely. So for example, let's say it should be a little bit less obvious of blue, and if I add another trans flag, you can see that it uses it again. It also does add history steps, so I can now undo create the trans flag, and it completely does that. It also names it accordingly. We can also add a text message, so let's say protect trans kids, and unfortunately the text field doesn't render perfectly, but it is what it is, I guess. As a bug for a moment, I can now add this, and as you can see, it inserts this text message. You can also add a padding to this text message, which is especially important if you have a flag that doesn't, like the trans flag, conveniently have white in the middle of it. So let's say we want to add a rainbow flag and just say the acronym LGBTQIA+, add the rainbow flag. I've added the padding, and as you can see, it has a little bit more padding. So without it, it would look like this, and with it, it adds just a little bit more padding. So I'll quickly undo these. I also have the non-binary flag. The colors aren't perfect at the moment, but it is what it is. And yeah, that's pretty much the whole plugin. And now let's look at some of the technical stuff around it. I'll quickly switch over to the code. And basically what we have is we have a simple HTML file, which contains, I mean, the text field, the checkbox. It still uses the, so quote unquote, old spectrum implementation that is built right into UXP, and then we have the action buttons for adding a trans flag, rainbow flag, and non-binary flag. Over in the JavaScript world, what we have is, I mean, we first of all import a bunch of stuff that we actually no longer need some of it, so let me quickly clean up that code. We just get references to these things, and then we add an event listener that basically creates a pride flag with a callback function for creating the trans flag or the rainbow flag and so on, and a history name. And why I wrapped it like this, you can see in a moment, because to have this work as I just showed you, where you can undo basically the whole operation as a single step, and also have these names up here, create rainbow flag and so on, what you have to do is you have to wrap everything, as far as I've learned already, based on some old ExtendScript forums I've found, in app.doScript, and then you can do something within basically the realm of doing the script. You can then, or you don't have to, I think, but you can specify script language, some arguments that you want this function to be called with. And then the important thing is that you have undo modes, which in this case is entire script, and then you can give it this history name, which then leads to this label in the edit undo or redo menu item. And the rest of the things, I'll quickly scroll over the code so you can look at it. So basically, we just get the text message and create a text with it if we have it. I'll quickly go to the create text one just so you can see it. We create a new text frame. What I had to learn basically the hard way was that in InDesign in the DOM, the child nodes of a layer, or I guess it's not a layer, but the child nodes of what would in XD be the scene graph, are basically divided into the different types of objects that they can be. So in this case, we have text frames, and so we add a new text frame. We set the vertical justification to center line. All these constants, by the way, have to be imported from the InDesign module using the require function. Then we just set the text of it, set a few more formatting options, and then we look at whether we want to have the padding. If we want to have the padding, we take from the margin preferences the column gutter of the page, which let me see if I can quickly find that. It should be under margins and columns, and this is basically this number right here, so the gutter, as far as I'm aware. And then what we do is just we set these bounds to basically use these kinds of things. And this margin preferences left, by the way, is basically this left margin from the page and so on. And another thing that I found a little bit unintuitive coming from the XD UXP world is that within InDesign, in the DOM, the bounds work basically as distance from the top, distance from the left, distance from the bottom, distance from the right, and not, for example, X, Y, width and height as the bounds. So with that, basically you have to go around the clock counterclockwise to get this, which I think is the same as in CSS, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, just something that took me by a surprise a little bit, where I had a bit of a debugging session where I just couldn't figure out why things weren't working. And what I found out was that I intuitively, thinking about X and then Y axis, had put the margin preferences left into the first item of that array, and that then simply doesn't work. And yeah, then basically we create these flags by calling a create stripes helper function. The create stripes helper function goes through each of the colors, and if it's not undefined, it creates a rectangle for it with this create stripe function on the parent node, with the specified color in an index of a total amount, and that then gets used to calculate the bounds of that layer or that rectangle. Stroke with a weight of 0, so that we disable the stroke and just the assigned fill color. And colors also have quite a unique way that they work in InDesign, because all the colors in the document basically have to be existent as these color fields or swatches right here, and they can also have this sort of folder structure. And so what I did to achieve that was I used a function absurd color, which basically, if the, I mean, it's not really absurd, it's kind of get or create. I probably should rename that. Let's quickly do that. Get or create color, and get or create color group. That makes much more sense. Yeah, absurd would be to update or insert, so yeah, it's not really updating it, but we basically look at the color, we take it by the name, which for example could be trans flag blue or something like that. And the weird thing about how InDesign works, in my opinion it's weird, that I had to get used to, is that this always returns your color. It never returns undefined. And the only way you can then figure out if this color actually already exists in a document is to check if this color is valid. And if it is not valid, then you have to create it. And then basically we create it in the active document with the name, the color value, and the parent color group, which I create down here as bright colors. That's this folder you saw right here, bright colors. And yeah, basically then we just return this color, and that allows us to then get or create the color in these places. Now, I've rambled on already quite some time, but I just thought it might be interesting to some of you who are already experienced with UXP from a different host app, and like me, are now starting to look into how it works in InDesign. I'm also always happy to show a little bit of Pride stuff also outside of Pride Month, so I wanted to use this video to quickly say that, hey, trans lives matter, please protect trans kids and don't discriminate against anybody just for who they are. And with that, my name is Zori Klaschka. I thank you very much for watching. Good luck on your plugin development journey. And with that, see you soon. Have a nice day.